Greetings, hi, the War Owl greets you, and I'm going to be showing you here once again another 5 versus 5 Counter-Strike Global Offensive match. And this one is going to be the conclusion here, game number 3 of this best of 3 series between compLexity and Ninjas in Pajamas, as I try, as I might, to stop the auto-director bug from switching players. So here we go, first round, and it will be the conclusion to the whole thing on train. I'm going to freak out about this auto-director thing. And they are away. This is, of course, an incredibly CT-sided map. It will favor the Ninjas in Pajamas. Ninjas in Pajamas here, definitely the best at CT side. Let's check out how they're going on T side. All of them walking inside. It looks like they are going to get ready to push here. Nothing and Gares are in position. Nothing has purchased an expensive smoke grenade. Look, Nothing and Gares both have a whole bunch. They will be trying to delay this push, but the Ninjas in Pajamas run past it, are now inside of the site. Gares here as well, trying to get frags. Nothing does go down, and are they able to take them down? Zephys moves around, takes out two players with some great headshots. Now just get right in for Flare and left. Oh, this could be a huge win here for compLexity to stop this pistol round, and it looks like Gidright does go down, so they will be defusing that bomb. Off to a great start here. Now that is incredibly important, because if Ninjas in Pajamas took that pistol round, then compLexity was going to be in some serious trouble on this map in particular, because it's a very difficult map to play T-side, and that pistol round gives them about 3 points. Sorry, the auto director thing is killing me here. I can't believe this. Needs to be fixed. All right, second round here. compLexity will be buying up for a third round buy from Ninjas in Pajamas. So they're buying FAMASes. They're buying weapons that they're going to be able to contend with the AK-47s with as well. And it looks like Ninjas in Pajamas are just going to be pushing inside. So here's Nothing with the mow down. And know what? Nothing is dead. Gares, the secondary player here, moves in. Freebetter able to just take him down. He's down to 17 health now. Doing a great job. He is dead. Bomb will get planted. That will mean there will be a third round buy. Nothing is not very happy. Mutters the name of our Lord and Savior in an unsavory way. And your Glock is solid. Admiring Freebetter, the player, the man. And we will have a defuse here. compLexity wins this round, but that was a win for Ninjas in Pajamas, because they will be able to buy third round full. Look at all of that money. Tons and tons of money. And here we go. Full AK-47 buy there. Someone needs to message me a workaround for this auto director bug. Driving me absolutely insane. All right. You know, if you were knifing people when they are dead at a China event, you could actually lose the game. Raffle. Yeah, I saw a bug on the ground. I was trying to kill it. Pasha style. Love the chatting going on here. Here's Forrest to throw a smoke middle, and then the terrace will push out middle. There it is. Both of the smokes, and it looks like they have a great smoke screen there to be able to push outside. Two players inside of the ladder. Here comes Freebetter inside of hell. He runs forward and picks out Hiko quite easily there. And looks like we do have one counter terrorist from the back. That's Nothing. Nothing trades himself. Now a 3 versus 2. Gares and Swag. Now a 2 versus 2. The bomb is down. Swag, the last player left. 1 versus 2. Can he do it? We have one player exist. Is low. Get right at full health. Bomb is planted. So disadvantage to Swag. They both know where he is. And Get Right is behind him, successfully maneuvers himself back there. Surprise that exists did not try and peek at that point to take the player on 2-1. Once again, the coordination of the Ninjas in Pajamas is something that I've seen just a little bit lacking in this series. All right, and here we go. Moving on to the next round, Ninjas in Pajamas taking third round with that AK-47 buy. They did have an advantage there in terms of weapons on that round. All right, we do have Ninjas in Pajamas. Already at 1 point, that is quite huge for them. Gares going to be purchased. They're actually, look at this. compLexity is doing an incredibly risky buy. Nothing and Gares buying these eco guns. We have a scout on Gares here. And Gares trying to watch and see if those players cross while Nothing waits here with the Mag 7. Already hit Dexist 2 times. Takes out Get Right. Great shot. Gares making sure nobody else crosses. We do have players pushing an Ivy as well, so here's Hiko to hold that off. One of them rotating back now. Ninjas in Pajamas just going for picks around the map. And they have whittled down the health here of the Ninjas in Pajamas, compLexity has. So this actually looks like a good round for compLexity. This could be a huge upset to the Ninjas in Pajamas, who thought they were going to take two rounds in a row. So that buy puts it to sort of an even level. Ninjas in Pajamas has the weapon advantage. compLexity has the side advantage. And now looks like they're getting taken down. Ninjas in Pajamas holding on to that lead. We'll have a full save here by compLexity next round. If Gares, 1v3, he only has to go for body shots at this point. His teammate should tell him that in terms of how many players are dinked. Look at that, 3 players, really low. Will be a bop, bop, bop goes the weasel. And we'll see what happens. And is waiting for those players. Nope, he's going to allow that bomb to go off, so he is saving, going for the exit frags. I'm not sure why he would want to save a scout. However, Gares has decided to do just that. He does have one frag with the thing, though. One player inside, looking to take him down. That is Exist. Gares, going for those exit frags. Looks like Exist might get the drop on him. And if he doesn't push out, he'll be good. And he decides to save that scout. So we're going to have a full save with a scout. Check out the money. They have nothing because of that risky buy. So this is going to be huge for the Ninjas in Pajamas. And so instead of saving, buying the next round and putting themselves at a huge advantage, they went for the sort of even surprise attack thing. I'm not sure how good that would be. You know, it's a huge gamble, and the gamble did not pay off. You can't judge a gamble after it happened, of course, because we know the outcome. If they had won that, which it looked like they almost were able to do, they would have, you know, put themselves back into the game with Ninjas in Pajamas at only 1 point. And of course, this round, not too terribly good for compLexity. They are going to get mowed down. Did not expect anything different. Gares now, 1v5 with the scout. And he misses. Let's see if saving that scout versus going for those weakened players was a good idea or not. And it looks like it will not be a good idea as he goes down to Forest, shooting him through the wall. All right. compLexity. Now, at 2 points, Ninjas in Pajamas very, very far ahead. This is Train. You want to get about 3 to 5 points on Train T-side. Train, of course, the most counter-terrorist-sided map that is played in competitive. Valve made a whole bunch of changes to their version of Train just recently to try and mix that up a bit. A lot of them very interesting changes. All right, Ninjas in Pajamas. Still inside of the spawn. Here is Exist and Gidright. Looks like Gidright's going to play entry frag. And Exist will be the backup to that. Well, Exist. No, Exist will now go forward. Just allowing Gidright to throw that smoke so Exist could go by. That was a pretty good nade there. Did some damage to Exist. Exist now gives himself away. They know where Exist is. And being very timid here, we have all of these players getting ready to push. There's nothing to hold it off. Nothing takes out both of those players. Terrace pushed down lower, but it looks like it is going to be a mow down here. Just get right left. He is still going forward, tries to shoot them through the smoke. Complete smoke screen down there, but that is just no win situation, and get right goes down. compLexity holds on. Now 3-3, we'll see if Ninjas in Pajamas definitely have money to buy, so it's another round they have to get another point. But they've already set themselves up at a good position in terms of points. 3 points, they can still win the game once they get to CT side. We know Ninjas in Pajamas has an incredibly strong CT side hold off here on Train. I don't know if compLexity will have what it takes to push through that once we get to that CT side. This is, of course, game number 3. The winner of this will win a whole bunch of money. And the loser will go home empty-handed, maybe home all the way to Sweden. All right. We do have Swag watching at Ivy. One player pushing forward there. That's Freebearer. All right, Swag. Pulling back a little bit. That nade should hit him. Right on him. He doesn't even move. 45 health left. Getting ready to push here at Ivy. Just going for picks. They're being very passive. All right, they're set up to take outside. They have one player to go outside connector area. They also have 2 players at Ivy and then 2 at the ladder. So it's a 2-1-2 split take. Let's see what they're going to be able to do here. Exist getting ready to push out. Smokes are now down and they are away. Looks like they're going to be pushing out now. Counter terrorists, only 2 of them left. Nothing and Senphis. Now going to be a 2v2. Get right and Faflaren versus nothing. Just nothing left. And looks like they are trying to get position on him. He's sneaking up from behind. They do get that bomb planted. Get right up inside of CT Heaven. And they don't seem to know where nothing is at this point. Nothing, gave himself away. Gonna be pushing up. Catches get right off guard just for Flaren left. And looks like they are gonna do a one versus one here. For Flaren sprays him down. Nothing will die. Great job there. The ninjas in pajamas take another point. That is so huge. They're now actually leading in points on T-side train. And they do have the eco advantage as well, money advantage. So looking up and up for the ninjas in pajamas. So here they go now. Ninjas in pajamas at 4 points. Looking good. Technical difficulties around. So they're doing this again. Doing 2-1-2 once again. These players are going to play inside. I doubt they're actually going to push here unless they get a pick. Two players watching inside. Now 3 players inside. It is a save here from the ninjas in pajamas. And look at the deagles. We got deagles on Swag and Symphys to hold this off. 3 players watching inside once again. Outside will be easy pickings. Terra setting up 2-1-2 again. They've got the bomb dropped because they're not going to try and do just a take because they know that they're saving at this point. Be a little bit more passive. The 2 players at Ivy come back. They're just going to do outside, all of them outside, to give themselves that distance advantage. So as we can see there on the mini-map in the top, they're just going to come from these 2 areas, outside, and then just push like this across. We have Hiko here to watch them and hold them. This is a shooting gallery here. Very difficult for the counter to... What? Boom! Headshot! Deagle with the swag takes him down. Ninjas in pajamas wins that easily. So we look at that again. It's actually a very scary strategy. They were going to do the 2-1-2. We have 2 players come out Ivy. One may go around the back. One may come this way. One player come through here with the bomb and go plant. That's after the smoke screen cuts it in half. And then 2 players come down the ladder. One goes over here. One goes on top of the train. One might also come out here by the electrical box. Instead, the players came back here. They all came outside from these 2 areas. And then they just pushed across in a line, like a shooting gallery. Very nice take. And, of course, they had to use those smokes to be able to do that, though. So here they go. Look like they're going to try it again. Ninjas in pajamas now pushing out middle. Smokescreen coming down to block off the Z-connector. 1 player over there going up into CT side heaven. We have players in the back by the train shooting long-distance shots. Only Freeberg has been dead. And look at those great smokes preventing all of these players now exist. Looks like he's going to try and sneak through behind enemy lines. He does get through. And does pick off the player there. And he is now dead. Going to be a 2 versus 3. Forrest just tries to plant the bomb, but that's not going to happen. Once again, back to a get right versus everybody. Get right 1 versus 3. Still got 100 health, and it looks like he is going for this. 50 seconds left. Nothing. Get right jumps up and down, kills his accuracy. He tries to control that spray pattern, but it does not happen. We see him pull down a little bit to the right because that is where that round was going to go at that point in time in the spray. So here we go. Complexity at 4. Ninjas in pajamas at 5. They are doing so well. Ninjas in pajamas, that is. 5 points now. They're set themselves up for the win, and they have 6 more rounds to do something with it. Complexity has to start feeling the pressure here. We'll check out their money. They were able to buy, but next round might have to be a save. It's difficult to buy on CT side, even with the blue shell effect. All right, smoke down. Players not pushing inside. That will delay them for just a little bit. Garrus can watch inside until that smoke clears. So smoke clears. Garrus watching and walking back inside to re-smoke it. And then should go back to the connector. Nothing pushed forward here as well. So they're set up 2-1-2 again. 2 Ivy, 1 outside. 2 ladder, with 1 player to watch inside just in case. And if he gets the pick inside, they may just push inside and grab that bomb. Alright. Waiting. And Zemphis gets picked at the ladder room. Very unfortunate for him. And now it looks like terrorists creeping forward may try to go inside. When a player is picked on counter-terrorist side, they have to sacrifice someone to watch one position. Probably the player who plays Z-connector. Rotate out so we don't have to worry about that player. So no, they're actually not going inside. They're getting ready now. 35 seconds left. They will call the push at about 30 seconds. There's the 30-second mark. Garrus holding them off over at the ladder. They have pushed outside. Here's Hiko. Good shot by Hiko. There's Forrest. Garrus and Forrest have come into contact. Get right now. And Freeber. 2 players left. Now a 2 versus 2, but it looks like Terrace have a huge disadvantage here. Hiko takes another player down, just Freeberg left, and Hiko takes him down as well. Look at that, man. Hiko, 3 frag with Garrus at 2. Nice round for Complexity to hold that off. putting it at 5-5. I won't say tie. It's tied in terms of score, but Ninjas in Pajamas is still definitely ahead. All right. Looking good, once again, for Ninjas in Pajamas, but however, this round looks like they will save. So, this save, let's see, they're probably just going to push inside. They've done that for a number of saves. And looks like Faflaren takes the time to purchase some flashes and smokes. They're just going to try and get the bomb down. So here's Garrus, watches them all cross with that auto sniper, calls in nothing to help him out. And now it's time to mow down the pistoling players. There's one by nothing. And Garrus on the other side, there's another. Here's Garrus to take out the rest. Oh, we got Sempus there as well to mow them down. Jumping forward, headshot, and they will defuse that bomb. That was very easy, but once again, Ninjas in Pajamas, that was a win for them because they got that bomb planted, gives them tons of money. That is the only purpose of those pistol rounds on train, is to throw your flashes and smokes in a very clever way to make really good use of the limited resources you have to get a bomb plant, and they were able to pull that off once again. So yeah, look at that, money, money, money! I do that like every time, I have to stop. I'm playing some Killing Floor. Alright, let's see what they set up once again. So I think they're going to continue with this standard setup that they've been doing. It's like a 2-1-2. One player watches inside, picks it a little bit, just to make sure. And they're not putting anybody at Ivy this time. We have two players here. By complexity to watch Ivy, so Swag has his attention distracted there. Terrace now pushing outside. Nothing runs forward. Does he see that player? Yes, he gets an idea of where he is, tries to hit him through the smoke. And Terrace pushing forward. Still pretty even at this point. Two versus two. Exist and Get Right versus Swag and Garrus. There is Swag taking out the player. And we do have a rotate by Get Right inside. He's got a minute. He can be sneaky. Pull out that weapon and walk now. No, he's still running. Garrus should hear this. And there's the player. Oh, tried to do a flick shot, but hit the train instead. And coming here to watch him. They had the bomb outside, so there's no reason for them to come inside. They could just watch that bomb. They know where Get Right is now, so they have a huge advantage. Get Right, don't jump. And going for this headshot. Oh, caught Garrus off guard. Looks like Get Right does die. Very nice job by Swag. Let me show you what happened there. We did have that one player watching here. That's Garrus, and we had Ninjas in Pajamas going against him. Through that flash, caused him to move to the side, while his other player, who was in here, moved out and then took the shot. Boom, takes out Get Right. So that was actually a really nice little 2-versus-1 that they did there. That's how you should play that game, is and always engage 2-on-1. One player is sort of a distraction, the other takes the shot and takes him down. So we have entry fraggers and support fraggers. And here's Faflare. Now look at all of those smokes and nades! Just gonna be doing a blitzkrieg, pushing outside through the defensive smoke. Look at that smoke screen! Incredible! Able to get that bomb planted inside of that smoke screen. Counter terrorists now have to retake it. 4-versus-3. They do have a little bit of an advantage here. Terrorists have been pushed fast. Here is Sempus on top of the train, pushing forward, spraying down these players. Now just gonna be Get Right left. 1-versus-2. Tries to come up behind him there on that train, and the Hiko flips around, takes him down, and they will be defusing that bomb. Great retake there by complexity, defusing that bomb, winning a point here, CT side, preventing Ninjas in Pajamas from getting too terribly far ahead. So now Ninjas in Pajamas at 5 points. 5 points is a good point to be, set themselves up for the win. Gonna be very difficult once it gets over to CT side for complexity to do much on T side against the CT side Ninjas in Pajamas. So going on to the next round, Ninjas in Pajamas has got plenty of money to buy on this round. Let's see how they set up. Looks like they're setting up 2-1-2 again, but they have that bomb over at B side. This is smart because they can take that bomb down ladder and go outside if they want, or if they get the pick here inside, they're able to go inside. And we see Garrus here watching this with an auto sniper. I think it was Get Right who started that trend. Ooh, Garrus. Player just jumped by, tries to get the drop off of him. And Garrus takes Get Right down. Garrus using Get Right's trick against him and taking him down. There's the defensive smoke. Nothing, watching out Ivy. We got players shooting through that smoke. And now it looks like Ninjas in Pajamas actually setting themselves up for a win here. 4-versus-3 with Garrus low. They've taken out Swag and Hiko with picks. Wow. And Ninjas in Pajamas have a huge opportunity here to take a point. They've got three players. One of them is low on health. And looks like they're going to come out here. Ivy, there's Sempus. Come on, Sempus. It's all up to Sempus now. Three players to push out here. Get smoked out. Now nothing up here could catch these players off guard. They really have to hope for that. Oh, they almost catch nothing off guard. Zemphis is dead. Just Garrison. It looked like ninjas in pajamas. We'll take another point here. This is huge. Garrus 1v3. It looks like he is going for it, not trying to save this huge, this very expensive auto sniper here for last round. And that's because they have enough money to buy next round. Don't worry. And here's Garrus. Oh, shows himself. Exist takes him down, and he is so incredibly dead. All right, that is that. compLexity at 8 points. Ninjas in Pajamas takes the 6 points. They are now really, really, really in a good position here as we move into the last round of the half. Counter-Terrorist able to buy again. Don't worry, tons of money. Terrorist, though, still able to buy as well. So another full buy versus full buy. And they're doing a 2-1-2 once again. Here's Garrus to watch inside with the auto sniper. Doesn't look like they even care about picking this time. Just making sure he does not push. Two players in Z here from CT. That's a little strange. Alright. They have that bomb drop. They are going for those picks. It looks like IV is the place where they're trying to pick. If they get the pick, they're going to push. 1 minute, 15 seconds. Waiting for defensive smokes to clear. There's a defensive smoke to block off the player at middle. Players at inside. Ninjas in pajamas here. Get right, get smoked down as well. Still waiting for the defensive smokes to clear, and then they will push. And it looks like they're going to do the 2-1-2 once again to take outside. And they've smoked off the left side. This may be an indication that they're pushing now at 50 seconds. Forest creeping forward just in case there's anybody lurking. Is that the term you guys use? Lurking? And they do pull back. It looks like there's another smoke that went out down there. Oh, Freebird goes down, and it looks like they have snuck by here, exist inside. May try to take this bomb inside and take bomb site B. compLexity sort of anticipating this. They have two players inside of Z just in case. Oh no, that's actually a player in the CT Heaven. Just looks like it on the minimap. Exist, ninja style, has snuck past all of these players. Boom, that was an easy little tap. Is behind Garrus. Counter-Terrorist in some trouble here from Exist. He does go down, though. Just Forest left. 1v3 doesn't happen. compLexity now ends the half 9-6. But still, Ninjas in Pajamas in a very good position. Now is the time to see what compLexity has made up. This is the moment that defines a team. They are going up against insurmountable odds here. Ninjas in Pajamas holding CT side train. Can they do it? Can they pull off this T side amazingness? We shall find out after the halftime is done. I will return. Alright, here we go. We are back. It is time for the epic conclusion to this epic series. Last half of game number 3 of the finals between, grand finals, between Ninjas in Pajamas, all the way from Sweden, playing against compLexity, the home team here, in the United States of America, with some Canadian players. And here they go. 6-9, compLexity has their work cut out for them. Big time. Can they pull off the comeback? That is the question. Pistol round is going to be it for them. They need to win this pistol round. This is so incredibly important for them to win this pistol round. And we'll see what they're going to do. They push outside. Looks like they will get the bomb planted. Nope, nothing. Sort of positioning himself. He's out in the open. Does not get the bomb planted. This is a huge disaster here. That did not work. What happened there? He tried to plant the bomb behind this thing. Where was the smoke? There was no smoke. The smoke was back here. He could have planted up here. I don't know. That was a huge disaster for compLexity. It may have just cost them this game. I didn't even know what they were trying to do there. It looked like they were doing a save eco strat to get bomb planted just for money, and they didn't have the smokes in proper positions. And nothing says smoke radar for the win. He's explaining what happened there. He's talking about being able to see players through the smoke on the radar and shooting where they are. We'll have an ego here. Ninjas in Pajamas buying in case terrorists do a third round buy as well. They have M4s and FAMAs to go after those AK-47s. And Hiko goes down. Now we have Semphis, who is dead. Ninjas in Pajamas, 8 points, compLexity at 9. Looking very bad for compLexity. Third round, will they buy? Won't they buy? They don't have the money, though. And they will eco once again. So we're going to have a third round save from compLexity. That is a possible point that they will not have. And here they go. Ninjas in Pajamas, though, has upgraded. Fuflarin, by the way, ding 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 ding, is opping. So it looks like Train is the only map where Fuflarin feels comfortable opping once again. I think Forest will take over the role if they need it on other maps. Nice to see him back in the role. Let's see how he does it. He will be playing inside with this thing. Get right helping as well. Terrace are getting ready to push inside and get the bomb planted. Op against Pistolers, not the best idea. Because if they steal that thing, that's huge. And you can only really kill one player at a time with the op. And Pistolers like to swarm you like little buzzing bees. Alright. The Flaren throws the smoke. This holds off the rush. They don't push. He puts Get right into position. He says, okay, they're saving. Pulls back to the back here to watch upper. Has Get right on the ground. Complexity not backing off. It looks like they are just going for this. Fuflarin missing a few shots here, but that's difficult. Player strafing around. And there is a smoke. That does not help them. Not sure what that was for. And Fuflarin still missing. Player is sort of taunting him, like, try and hit me, buddy. Just try and hit me! Get right as the players try to push down here. Oh my gosh! We're getting an owl vision on all four of those, though. Don't worry. Here's Fuflarin at lower. Get right now. Moving in from the back. Sneaky beaky-like. As Semphis, the last player left, goes down to Forest. Let's get an owl vision on Get right. Lovely. I know he's got to see those pistol shots twice, but that was so incredibly good. And Semphis says, battle me like a man, Fif. And Fuflarin says, no. Not sure what that was all about. Fuflarin, why would he push and charge him? Didn't make sense. Complexity throwing some taunts out there. Have to be feeling the pressure. We'll be buying here fourth round, and we'll just be pushing outside. So here they go. Tons of flashes, tons of smoke. They push through the smokes. We have a player up there at CT. Exist is on the ground watching this, trying to hold it off. Terra's trying to push out, but they are going down. Fuflarin has rotated to help with this. Two players inside, one player inside of Z, one at CT Heaven. They aren't really know about the player at CT Heaven. That was Forest. Now it is going to be a 2v2. Fuflarin in the Pasha spot with the AWP. Does take out Hiko with a great shot. Now just Semphis left. Fuflarin going for the shot. Oh, he goes down. Now a 1v1. Semphis, who is at 3 frags now, Get right. Waiting for him. The bomb is down way behind him. Semphis does not know where this player is. He's looking around. He's given himself away by jumping up that ladder and making all of that noise. He's checking positions, trying to get position on Get right before he goes for this bomb. It's just his movements are a little bit strange. He's put himself sort of in the open. 35 seconds left. It doesn't look like he's going for the bomb. He thinks, if I grab that bomb, I'm dead. He's hiding somewhere. So Semphis waits, but, I mean, Get right wins in a wait situation, so I'm not sure why he's doing this. Get right doesn't have to move, and he wisely isn't. He's listening for a bomb pickup. So this is just a very strange strategy, and Get right knows where he is. He can hear him the entire time. He hears him now. He says, could be going B. Nope, I hear him outside. He has to plant. Get right now will play the bomb. We'll charge forward and takes him out quite easily. Semphis making mistakes there. That was, I don't know, Get right. Played that how you should. He just waited, listened, played it smart. All right, here we go. Ninjas in Pajamas at 10 points, Complexity at 9. And they will have to save once again. They haven't made a dent in the... Oh, no, they're buying. Don't worry, guys. They are buying. They are going for it. Here we go. Galil, AK-47 push of Doom. Blue Shell effect in full effect. Next round should be able to buy as well. And here they go. Doing a 2-1-2. Sure what swag. Oh, he's in this position to throw things, I guess. And here's nothing. Does get smoked out. Get right takes full position of the Oh, Get right another shot through the smoke. Ah, nothing gives himself away by shooting. Get right takes him down. When you shoot through the smoke, you want to strafe away as fast as possible because you've given away your position. A player can shoot through the smoke as well. There's a re-smoke there. Don't even allow them to have the back halls. Complexity was not doing this. To the Ninjas in Pajamas. Ninjas in Pajamas preventing them from taking any ground here. Alright, we do have Swag and Gears over here at B. We have players sneaking up behind them. Get right does go down. So it looks like they will be able to tank the site. Flaren on the ground with an AWP. Wants to pull back and go upper as all of his teammates rotate here to help with this. Oh, but Flaren stays on the ground and takes out Swag close range. And they're spraying through the smoke. Garrus is finally dead. Flaren with a good round, taking those two AWP shots. And Get Right continuing to shoot players through the smoke. Alright, Ninjas in Pajamas still holding it on here. No points for compLexity. This is what I was worried of. And actually, looks like we will have another save here by these players. And we have another Deagle on the field. We have P250s. P250s a little bit better in terms of economy. Then the Deagle. P250 only costs 300. Deagle is super expensive. And looks like we have... Oh, Darius outside exists. Takes out Swag. Bomb is still in spawn. What was that all about? Gare is still inside of spawn. Now is moving, bringing that bomb maybe to go ladder. Exist is watching the ladder, though. And maybe taking that bomb inside. Nothing was inside, just blew up from a nade. And it looks like Terrors are going to commit to this inside push. Three counter Terrors watching them. They're not even going to be able to get this bomb down. They've smoked off their escape as well, so they're not getting out of there. And for Flaren at upper, making sure nobody peeks, finally takes out Sempus, who's been taunting him his whole game up from up there. We have a player sneaking up from behind. Here's Forrest. Sneaky beaky like. Player jumping into his face. And Forrest is now in position, but Get Right will be the one to go for the frag. No, Forrest just takes him through the smoke. So Ninjas in Pajamas holds off a pistol push, prevents a bomb plant. Ninjas in Pajamas takes more position on CT side, it seems like. They block it off like here, so players can't push. I haven't seen where they've been blocking off in other positions, but it looks like they block off here. They block off here by putting a player to watch up here. Probably block off here. I'm not sure if they give them this, though. So let's actually look this round, as it's a full save round, how they block off different positions. So yeah, they do have the player up on top of the train. They smoke off inside, so they can't push there. And Flaren plays Pasha's spot, so they sort of give them Ivy. We have two players there at Ivy. Garrus has been boosted up. I don't know if they know about him up here, though. You can get boosted up onto the little grate thing there. Defensive smoke. Flaren takes a pick. And Exist is waiting for players to push down the ladder. compLexity setting up. They've dropped that bomb, so it looks like they're going for picks. They've lost one player already. That is huge. Ninjas in Pajamas, CT side, they've been taking a lot of picks, taking players down. compLexity, then, with lower numbers, is not able to push anywhere. On T side, a lot of times, it looks like what they're trying to do is go for picks. All right, two players have dropped down the ladder, forced Exist back a little bit. Nothing does go down, so we have two picks already off of compLexity. Three players left, and looks like they're getting ready to try to push outside, but this is not going to be easy. And looks like they are getting mowed down. Just Hiko left, and he does go down. So, yeah, compLexity not able to really make anything happen here. They're not getting the picks. Instead, Ninjas in Pajamas is getting the picks, putting them at a huge disadvantage on every round. They're not able to really make anything happen. And compLexity has not figured out a way to do anything about it. As they move around the map and try and position themselves, they get players picked off. So when they finally are ready to do the push, it is just, it's not going to happen. All right, going to be smoking, maybe doing a blitzkrieg here and just trying to push very quickly outside. Let's see if it works out for them. Let's see if Ninjas in Pajamas is expecting this. Lots of smokes and flashes outside as the terrorists push out. They do have position out here. Forest does go down. Smokes are down. Perfect smokes. We'll be trying to plant that thing before taking out the players. That's nothing inside of that smoke. Hiko has snuck by over at Ivy. Will be coming in from behind them now. Get Right at Z connector. Counter terrorists have been pushed completely out of A. Huge advantage here to the terrorists. Just for Flaren left inside of CT spawn. The Blitzkrieg has worked, and he will try to save this AWP. Congratulations, compLexity. Finally has defeated the Ninjas in Pajamas on this CT side. This may be it for them. They may have figured out how to do this thing, and it's just to push in there very fast with those five players. And now, Flaren has players on all sides of him converging. He's trying to survive. Players pushing up B. One inside of CT spawn. He has no escape! And he dies! He takes out Swag before he dies. Will not get that off, but don't worry. Ninjas in Pajamas has won so many rounds in a row. Look at that money. However, compLexity finally wins a round. Let's see if they just try the same thing. It worked. Finally found something that worked. Let's see if they do it again. Ninjas in Pajamas doesn't play very dynamically compared to other teams, especially on CT side, so they may just play the same way. No, this time they don't have Exist up on top of that train, so Exist has pulled back inside of the site, and compLexity is now playing passive once again. They have players at inside trying to pick. That smoke forced to get right forward. Defensive smoke there. They do have control of the back halls at B, but doesn't look like they're taking advantage of that. They're just sitting back, which is fine, biding their time. And now looks like they are pushing outside. They're outside once again. They have the smokes down. They cannot plant the bomb, though, based on those smokes. They're just a little bit too far towards them, but Swag goes for the plant anyway. Forrest does not hear that because of all the flashes that are going on. Get Right hears it, pops out, and takes him down before the smoke happens. Hiko comes in from Ivy once again, and now it is a 2v3. Bomb down inside of the site. We do have Symphys sneaking up from... Oh, the bomb has actually been planted. You hear the ticker. And they both do go down, though. Will be a defuse by the ninjas in pajamas, putting themselves at 14 points. As they come here for the end of this game, 14 points, 16 is the winner. Two rounds left for the ninjas in pajamas to nail the final nail in the coffin, defeat compLexity, and win the grand finals. And compLexity here, forced to buy. They don't want to tie it up. They just want to go for the win. And we do have a gun on Symphys, so they will be buying here. We'll be going for it. Let's see what they do this time. We're able to win that one round. Very exciting. But that last round, they were so close. All right. Maybe moving Exist back was that was the thing that made what compLexity did there, since they sort of did the same take just a little bit later. Maybe moving Exist back a bit was what helped. All right. Defensive smokes are all now down. So now we have to wait until 55 seconds. Defensive smokes inside as well. I don't see any, actually. And Get Right now just throwing it. Those two players do cross. I wonder if Get Right heard that. Doesn't look like he heard that. Two players now at upper. Faflaren pulls back to watch upper, so it looks like Get Right did hear that. Called the rotate for Faflaren to watch upper. And misses the player. Now this would have been very smart for Terrace to do an A-side push at this time, because they have three players on ninjas in pajamas rotated inside to watch for this. Instead, they have one player sort of baiting him around. Forrest sneaking up. He's going to go sneaky-beaky-like here. And here comes Forrest. Oh, just saw him. That smoke. Oh, what? Faflaren takes out Symphys through that smoke he just threw. Now it looks like Terrace are getting ready to push inside. They did not out-juke ninjas in pajamas. Instead, they're just going to be pushing inside. And here's Forrest to hold it off. Actually are able to take them down. Will have the site just based on shooting them, even though they went for against a B side take with three players already there. Counter Terrace have rotated. 3v3 for the retake. They are trying to get that bomb down. And here's Faflaren at upper still with his off, taking players down. Freebird as well. Now they have to work 2v1 against Swag. Just misses him through the smoke. Takes him down. Freebird will defuse that bomb, and Ninjas in Pajamas will be at 15 points. compLexity. Oh man, they pushed inside like this. They had players around the back here. Ninjas in Pajamas rotated, so they had three players inside. Ninjas in Pajamas hadn't, compLexity hadn't lost a player. They could have rotated around down ladder, had the one player come out here, taken outside, smoked out Z, and then that would be it. Ninjas in Pajamas couldn't push out. They'd have to go all the way around here, and they could have won that. Instead, they assumed that Ninjas in Pajamas was going to rotate back into their standard position after that amount of time, which they did not. They stayed with that three players inside. All right, here's Freebird to make sure. Freebird, I'm not going to get it, don't worry. And watching at Ivy. 2-1-2 here from compLexity. 15 points for the Ninjas in Pajamas. One more point, and that will be it. They will win. Faflaren picks off Gears. That is going to hurt them. That has to hurt. Hiko here. Could pick up that weapon off of Gears. Not going to happen. Just waiting. Almost reaching the 55-second mark. Smokes will start to clear. And there's Swag. Swag gets shot in the hip. Faflaren picks off another player. Faflaren has been really doing well for his team now. Only two players left. Two Terrace. Counter Terrace moving outside to deal with this. Just nothing left. And he does go down. Ninjas in Pajamas will win that thing. Congratulations to the Ninjas in Pajamas. compLexity, trying to hold it off, was not able to defeat the defenses of the ninjas in pajamas. Thank you folks very much for watching. I am the War Owl, and I still have no closer.